बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलामु अलैकुम। दिस इज़ डॉक्टर शगुफ्ता अंदलीब, प्रोफेसर ऑफ जूलॉजी, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन। आई एम हेयर टू टीच यू द कोर्स जू जोग्राफी एंड पेलियंटोलॉजी। दिस कोर्स इज कम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू मेजर ब्रांचेज ऑफ जूलॉजी। नंबर वन, जू जोग्राफी, विच डील्स विद द स्टडी ऑफ एनिमल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ओवर द प्लैनेट अर्थ। एंड सेकेंडली, पेलियंटोलॉजी, which deals with the study of fossils, and it gives us very important information regarding zoo geography and evolution of animal life. Today we will study the evolutionary history of man, and we will learn that how today's modern man has evolved from its ancestor. Before we study this topic, we must have concept of geologic time scale, theories of evolution, processes and types of fossilization, and dating of the fossil record. All of these will help us in grasping the concept of evolution. Human evolution is defined as the process by which human being developed on Earth from now extinct primates. We try to trace out all the ancestor primates from whom we have evolved into what we are today. Louis Leakey, a renowned paleoanthropologist, declares that theories on prehistory and early man change with every new evidence. It means information regarding evolution till today cannot be considered as the final, but it keeps on changing with every new discovery. It is believed by most of the paleoanthropologists that human has emerged in Africa about 315,000 years ago, and we are now the only living members of human tribe hominin. Fossil evidences indicate that our species Homo sapiens also coexisted for a time with Homo neanderthalensis. Well, this is dendrogram showing the phyletic lineage of primates. It shows that primates originated about 60 million years ago, and the ancestral primate splitted into two main groups, prosimians and anthropoids. Prosimians are also known as before monkey groups, and they include lemurs, lorises, tarsiers, and protos. Primarily, they were herbivorous and nocturnal, and only few survive today. Anthropoids include New World monkeys, Old World monkeys, gibbons, orangutans, gorillas, chimpanzees, and humans. This is the estimated time period of origin of early primates. First prosimians evolved 65 million years ago in early Paleocene, while first monkeys appear in early Oligocene, then first apes in early Miocene, and then first hominids emerged. The earliest primates had two distinct features through evolution that allowed them to succeed in the arboreal insect-eating environment. The first one is grasping fingers and toes and opposable thumbs, which allowed them to grip limbs, hang from branches, and use tools. And the other one is overlapping binocular vision, which lets the brain judge the distance precisely. Early primates share certain physical and social traits. They have dense hair or fur entire the body. They were warm-blooded, They have to nourish and care to their infants for a certain period of time. They also had social interaction and enjoying the active life through playing. They were keen observer and intelligent enough to imitate the actions. The oldest known ancestor of primates is Archonta, which is derived from Greek word archon, which means ruler. It is a group of placental mammals which emerged 65 million years ago. It gave rise to primates, tree shrews, bats, and flying lemurs. They were small arboreal animals with large eyes. They were insectivorous and nocturnal. They performed their foraging activities during night. Primates diverged into two main lineages: prosimians, the lower primates, and anthropoids, the higher primates. Anthropoids further diverged into three main groups: Old World monkeys, New World monkeys, and hominoids. Hominoids further evolved into apes and hominins. And hominins further evolved into Australopithecus and Homo. Prosimians are the primates lived before appearance of monkeys in the world. They largely inhabited North America, Asia, Africa, and Europe. They had large, forwardly directed eyes with five digits on fore and hind limbs. There was variation in their size. They ranged from mouse to cat. They were tree dwellers and nocturnal. Members of the two families of early Cenozoic primates are considered as the ancestor of prosimians and anthropoids. The Omomid family inhabited North America, Asia, and Europe, and they were considered as the possible ancestors to anthropoids. While members of the Adapid family, they are considered as ancestor to lemur loris line. North Arctos, belonging to family Adapidae, is extinct genus in early Eocene and resembles with modern lemurs. It is well known from complete fossil remains found in Europe and North America. Anthropoids branched off from prosimian during Eocene. They were diurnal, herbivorous. They have nurtured brain and gregarious, and due to this, they were quite social. They also gave parental care to their young ones. They developed color vision, and they have more forward rotated eyes with fully enclosed bony socket and molar cusps. Among early anthropoids, parapithecids and proplyopithecids are believed to be ancestors to Old and New World monkeys. Parapithecids are monkey-like and discovered from Egypt belonging to Oligocene, while proplyopithecids were ape-like and existed 35 million years ago in Egypt. Egyptopithecus xeoxys is believed to be one of the oldest anthropoids by paleoanthropologists. This is the imaginative painting based on the skeletal features of the fossilized skull. In this fossilized skull, you can see the prognathic face, sharp incisors, and canines. The Old World monkeys were ground dwellers. Some were arboreal. The nose were pointed downwards. They had thick toughened pads of skin, which is also called as ischial pad, to sit upon. They had no prehensile tail, and they included baboon, mandrills, pigtail macaca. You can see the nose pointed downward. The New World monkeys, they appeared 30 million years ago in South America. They were arboreal with flat nose and prehensile tail, including squirrel, monkey, and capuchins. Modern anthropoids emerged during Miocene, and they are believed to be ancestor to hominoids. Proconsul was the most distinct anthropoid of early Miocene in East Africa. It is ancient primate with sharing characteristics with monkeys and apes. This is proposed skull and appearance of Proconsul africanus. Eniapithecus was prominent anthropoid of middle Miocene, having similarity in structure and shape of molars with those of modern hominoids. During late Miocene, they migrated to Europe and Asia and diverged widely into Cevapithecus, Dryopithecus, Gigantopithecus, and Oreopithecus. Cevapithecus existed between 12.5 to 10.5 million years ago. They were large-bodied hominoids, and they were orangutan-like and also considered as ancestor to orangutans. They have thick enamel molars to feed on soft fruits. Dryopithecus is genus of extinct great apes, which emerged during 12.5 to 11.1 million years ago in Europe during middle and late Miocene. They are ancestors to gibbons, siamangs, and great apes. They have shorter forelimbs than hind limbs. Oreopithecus lived 11.6 to 3.6 million years ago. It is also known as mountain ape. Although they were not bipedal, yet fond of upright standing, and they are extinct genus of hominoid primate. Gigantopithecus is the largest primate, about 10 feet tall, 600 pounds average weight, and it existed between 2 million years ago to 100,000 years ago. It coexisted with Homo erectus in Pleistocene, and now it has become extinct. It is considered as sister genus of Pongo. Third branch of anthropoid is hominoid, which originated from Old World monkey and is considered as human line. It diverged into ape and hominins. Ape include gorilla, orangutans, gibbons, and chimpanzee. Apes have larger brain than monkeys. They lack tails. They have long arms and short legs, mostly larger than monkey except gibbon. Gibbon and orangutans are arboreal. Gorilla and chimpanzee are highly social. They have adaptable behavior, and they are found in Africa and Asia. Hominins include humans, their relatives, and their ancestors. They emerged during Pleistocene, and Pleistocene is also called as epoch of human life. Pleistocene is divided into further three time periods: lower Pleistocene, middle Pleistocene, and upper Pleistocene. Lower Pleistocene ranges from 2 to 1 million years ago, and Australopithecus and early Homo were the prominent genera in this time period. During Middle Pleistocene, Homo erectus and archaic Homo sapiens were prominent, and they existed during 1 million years ago to 130,000 years ago. During Upper Pleistocene, modern Homo sapiens evolved about 130,000 to 10,000 years ago. Sahelanthropus chadensis was discovered in Chad in 2002, and it existed about 7 million years ago. It is the oldest known hominid. This map is indicating the fossil excavation sites of hominin in Ethiopia. Hominid diverged into three genera, among which two were major. The first, Australopithecus, the second, Homo, and the third minor genus was Ardipithecus, which existed about 4.4 million years ago, and it was discovered in 1992. This was the human evolution from its ancestors. Dear students, I hope you have learned. Thank you very much.